in this, and I think we're across an important line. Tell me why I'm wrong here. Am I watching the state, the powers of the state, be directed against citizens of the United States by elected office holders abusing their power? Am I watching an abuse of power with regard to Hunter Biden and the Justice Department? Because truthfully, I don't understand why the tax delinquency for Hunter Biden seems to be treated as a crime uniquely among 340 million American citizens, just like the gun crime or charges. And secondly, right, you have a chairman of a congressional committee, Comer, who routinely makes criminal allegations as a committee chairman investigating matters of fact. And you have all of this playing out at a moment when Donald Trump, who commands everything behind the scenes, is promising mass deportations, concentration camps, and the locking up of political prisoners. So before the hurricane reaches the shores, the weather picks up. And I guess, unimpeachably so to me, what I'm watching is the levers of the state, the power of the state, the substantial powers of the legislative branch, the Justice Department, be leveled in a way that is indisputably, it seems to me, singular, venomous, directed for political purposes at the president, but more ominously, the destruction of his surviving son, who is a larger societal matter. No matter what it is that he has done, we should all want him to live in grace and recovery, or at least I thought that's what.
And he's never been a government employee.
He's never going to be a government employee. He's never going to hold elected office. Yeah, he's never going to hold a position of public trust. But it doesn't mean,
and never did, by the way.
Right, never did.
From children.
And well, he was an officer in the U.S. Navy, and he was forced out. But he will never hold a position of public trust. So we should, decency. Maybe we have a lot of people recovering from addiction in the country. You want people to be able to contribute positively, and certainly as a guy in his early 50s, he has a lot of room for that. But am I watching, right, that something that was impossible to conceive of growing up, that am I watching the state target and attack a citizen who happens to be the president's son with kind of a reverse fortunate son syndrome, where we're going to come after your family? This is the mob era of politics, isn't it?
It's shocking and startling. And I think you capture it very well. This is truly the weaponization of the federal government by the House Republicans. And the irony, of course, is that they created a subcommittee called the Weaponization of the Federal Government, which has not uncovered any weaponization of the federal government during the Biden presidency, although we have touched upon a lot of weaponization during the Trump presidency. But this is absolutely abusing their power for purely political purposes, and in an effort not just to muddy up the president, but to actually imprison a private citizen. And the House Republicans wrote a letter to Hunter Biden's judge urging her to reject his plea deal. That is gross improper conduct for the legislative branch to try to interfere in an ongoing prosecution in the executive branch, in the Department of Justice. And it is slanderous, for sure, because it is so baseless and frivolous. And because whatever Hunter Biden may have done, and there's no question that he engaged in misconduct, the Department of Justice did an investigative colonoscopy on him for 5 years. And we had testimony in the Oversight Committee. They interviewed over 60 witnesses. They got hundreds of thousands of documents. And I can tell you that for a $2 million tax fraud investigation, that is a tremendous amount of resources. That is a lot of time.
What did it cost? If you had to put a number on it.
It's hard. I mean, I don't know how you measure it, but it was thousands of man hours. Thousands of man hours. And they ultimately concluded that he did not commit a FARA violation, that he was not lobbying on behalf of anybody, even though he had business interests overseas, and that he was not money laundering, and that he was not doing any of these other crimes outside of the possession of the gun and the potential tax fraud. And so he should be dealt with. I mean, the Department of Justice should do it. I do think that the Republicans have had an influence on undoing the plea agreement, which, by the way, was only different because of Hunter Biden's concern that Donald Trump would become president and would retributively and politically prosecute him. But there's no evidence connecting any of that activity to President Biden. And we've been doing this a year. They will claim this week, Steve, the Republicans will claim that they need an formal impeachment inquiry because they've been, quote, stonewalled. I can tell you, because I led the impeachment of Donald Trump, provided zero documents to the impeachment investigation. Zero. The Biden administration has provided close to 75,000 documents from the archives, 2,000 pages of Treasury reports, FBI documents, more than 10 government witnesses. They've obtained 36,000 or 37,000 pages of bank records. There's no dearth of material. There's just a dearth of inculpatory evidence. And they are trying to use smoke and mirrors and to gaslight the American people into thinking that because they either have a lot of documents, Joe Biden did something, or that because a couple witnesses, lower level witnesses at the Department of Justice, whose bosses have already testified, are not being allowed to testify, that somehow that's obstruction. There's no new evidence here. From the first impeachment hearing in September, where their own witnesses, the Republican known witness, Jonathan Turley, who has turned into a complete hack for the congressional Republicans, even had said himself that there is not insufficient evidence to move forward with impeachment. And yet here they are moving forward with impeachment, even though they have gotten no new evidence. The only evidence that they have cited since then are loans that Joe Biden gave to his brother and his son and that were paid back.
Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe to our channel so you never miss a video. Also, for more content just like this, please consider joining our Warning Premium community. You can find out more in the description below.